Hello students, welcome to Newton Gate Academy. How are you all? Fine? Okay, I hope you are doing well. Now, I'm here to discuss about this year, 2021 NEET questions and answers of physics. Basically, I'll discuss all the NEET questions and answers in physics in four parts. This is first part. In first part, I'll cover from unit and dimensions to gravitation. In second part, I'll discuss elasticity to oscillation. And in third part, I'll discuss electricity and magnetism. And in fourth part, I'll discuss light and modern physics. Okay, so this is first part here, and I hope you enjoy this video. So, let's start. Okay, students, let's start. Okay, this is basically from physics, and our topic will cover from unit and dimensions to gravitation. Okay, so this is our first question, and obviously this is from unit and dimensions. Okay. So try from yourself first, because whenever you are saying this video from learning purpose, so you should try it from yourself first, then you just see the solution of this video. Okay, so just pause the video and try it. So okay, if you done, then very good. If you're not done, then just see. Here our question is, if force F, acceleration A, and time T is chosen as the fundamental physical quantities, find the dimensions of energy. Okay, so as we know, if you read properly in this chapter, as we know that mass, length, time, etc., these are base quantities and these are fundamental physical quantity. Okay, so we know all the dimensions of these fundamental quantities, but here our in this question they given certain physical quantities like force, acceleration, time. Just find dimension of energy using these force, acceleration, and time. These are physical quantity. Okay, so as we know that dimension of energy is same as dimension of work done. Okay, so the equation of work done, that is W, is equals to force into displacement. Okay, so we get this force as a fundamental quantity, but displacement is not fundamental here, so you must change displacement into acceleration and time. So let's see how to change it. So as you know that S, displacement, is equals to velocity into time, and we also know that velocity equals to acceleration by into t, because acceleration means velocity by t, change in velocity with change in time, so v by t in this dimensional equation. Okay, so a into t into firstly is t is here, so a into t squared, this is displacement. So just put him over here, f into a into t square. So f is fundamental, so that is dimension of wave is given here, f, capital F, into a, acceleration, dimension is capital A, and t, so that is t, capital T, the dimension of small t is capital T and square. So this is our answer, F A capital T square, that means option C. Option C is the right answer. Okay, this is next question. A particle is released from height s. Okay, this is from straight line motion. Okay, height s from the surface of the earth. So this is our earth surface, and a particle released from this point. Sorry. Okay. So particle released from this point. So well, this is check as point A. So particle released from this point and it goes to ground. Okay, this is basically free fall. Okay. So after certain time, it says that at a certain height, its kinetic energy is 3 times of its potential energy. The height from the surface of the earth and the speed of the particle at that instant are respectively. Okay, so we have to find here, that is height from the surface and speed of the particle, where kinetic energy is 3 times of its potential energy. So this particle is in free fall and is falling. Suppose if we take a second point over here, that is B point, here this criteria is fulfilled. Just take. Okay, at B point, this criteria is fulfilled. Okay, suppose we take this height is h from the ground. Okay, from the ground to this B point is h. Okay, so at this B point, here kinetic energy is 3 times of its potential energy. So just this is h, and another thing we have to calculate, that is speed of the particle. So let's take speed of the particle at point B is v. Okay, so from the equation, okay, from try it from yourself. Okay, after that you just see the solution. Just pause the video. Okay, okay, if you done, then very good, you are excellent, and if you not done, then see. So from the equation of motion, that is v square equals to u square plus 2a into s. This is our equation. So if we apply this equation in this situation, that is here we take v, that is v square is m, u square, that is initial velocity. The particle is start from A. So at point A, particle is in rest. So that means u equals to 0. Okay, so initially u equals to 0, so 0 square plus 2 into g over m, because acceleration in this case, acceleration is in g, so all time particle in acceleration, that is g for free fall. So that is g, and s means the height covered by this particle from A to B. If we take, okay, here height from the surface and the release point, this distance is given here s. So what should be the distance a distance between A and B? Obviously total distance is s, and this distance is h, that means s minus h. Clear? So v equals to root over 2g s minus h. Okay, so we got v. Now our criteria is, at point B, kinetic energy is 3 times of its potential energy. Let's take that this particle having mass is m. Okay, then what should be the kinetic energy? Of course, half m into v square. Kinetic energy at where? At point B, you should maintain this criteria, because in question they give us that kinetic energy is 3 times of its potential energy at where? At something point we take as B. Okay. So half mv square is equals to kinetic energy is 3 times of its potential energy. So at height h, what is potential energy of that point or at that particle? That is mg into h. Clear? So this is potential energy, this is kinetic energy, and 3 times of the potential energy is equals to kinetic energy. So mm gets cancelled, and okay, now we want to find, okay, just put V over here. So just half into V, means V square, means just root over to cancel करके हम V square का क्या लिख सकते हैं, 2G into S minus H. So that is 2G S minus H, which equals to 3 into G into H. 2 gets cancelled and G cancel, so H equals to okay, here another part, another, okay, just okay, so S minus H equals to 3H. That means 4H is quite similar. 4H equals to S, then H equals to S by 4. So S by 4 in the given option 1, 2 and 3. Okay. Okay. So you need to find V also. That's after that you can choose one option. Okay. Okay, our second question is speed of the particle at that instant. So what's the value of V you need to find here? So V equals to root over 2 into G into S minus H, S, and value of H is S minus 4, S by 4, sorry. Then the value of V should be, this is 4S minus S, that is 3S. So 3S and this is 4. So 3, that should be 3GS divided by, this is whole root over, okay, divided by 2, because this 2 and 4 get cancel out and 2 over here. So 3GS by 2, root over 3GS by, this is option A. S by 4 is the height and root over 3GS is the velocity. So option A is the guidance. Okay, this is third question. Just try it. This is also from unit and dimension. Okay. So if E and G respectively denote energy and gravitational constant, as you all know, that then E by G has the dimensions of. Okay. So just try it. Okay. So if you done, then great. As you know that E means energy, so we already know the dimension of, sorry, dimension of energy is m l squared e to the power minus 2, and dimension of G, if you remember it, that's okay, but if you don't remember it, that G, then you need to find it G first. Okay, so just take that equation, that is Newton's gravitational formula, F equals to G into m1 m2 divided by r square. This is mass of two bodies and this is distance between them, and this is force. So what should be G? G means F into r square divided by m, and m dimensionally both are mass, so that is mass square. Okay, so just put the dimension of F, ml to the power minus 2, this is R means length, L square divided by M square. So that is m inverse, because this m and this m cancel out and one m is remaining, that is m inverse, l square and n, that is l cube into t to the power minus 2. Okay, so this is dimension of g. Just put it e by g in equation, that is e by g means m l square to the power minus 2 divided by m inverse l cube t, sorry, that is t to the power minus 2. Just calculate it, that is m to the power minus 2, sorry, m inverse is whenever it goes up, that is m square, l cube and l square, that is l is remaining, so in numerator that is l inverse and t to the minus 2 and t to the minus 2, these are get cancelled, that is t is here but power is 0, because that is dimension of t is not here, so option should be equals to 2, option 2 is our right answer. Clear? Okay. This is also from unit and dimension. Okay. So you know, for NEET exam or whatever, this first chapter is very very important. This is very simple chapter, but many questions are arrived from this chapter. So you must do it properly. Okay. Just practice it, and this is very good for your scoring. Okay, let's try it. A screw gauge gives the following readings when used to measure the diameter of a wire. Okay, actually hum jab wire ka diameter measure karna chahte hain to hum screw gauge ka istemal karte hain. Okay, so then main scale reading is 0 millimeter. If you know about screw gauge, what is screw gauge, then you should know what is main scale, that is like this, this is main scale and one is vernier scale there, so that circular scale, that is that scale reading 52 division. Okay, so like this circular scale are there. Whenever nothing is in measure condition, that is whenever this scale is not used, this zero reading of circular scale and this is main scale reading should be coincide. Okay, after that whenever we rotate it, this main scale is coming out. Okay, and suppose this is millimeter scale, suppose this is zero reading, this is 1 millimeter, then 2 millimeter, then 3 millimeter, 4 millimeter, whatever. Okay, so like this we are measuring vernier reading and main scale reading. After that we measure diameter of the whatever wire bagara. Okay, the given that 1 millimeter, this is the reading, and the given that 1 millimeter on the main scale correspond to 100 divisions of the circular scale, that means whenever jab a 1 millimeter main scale reading shift hota hai to yahan par 100 circular जो रीडिंग्स होता है वो सर्कुलेट हो जाता है, सो जीरो जीरो से स्टार्ट करके 10 देन 20 देन डट 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 ऐसे करके सर्कुलर होता है 90 देन डट 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 देन जीरो विल कम आउट, दैट इज 100. ओके, सो व्हेनेवर इट क्रॉसेस 0 टू 90 देन 100, मेन स्केल शिफ्टेड फ्रॉम 0 टू 1, देन फर्दर आफ्टर क्रॉसिंग 0 then it goes to 1 to 2, okay, 1 millimeter to 2 millimeter, okay, like this. So the diameter of the wire from the above data, data means here, this is data, main scale reading is 0 and circular scale reading is 52. So first you need to find least count. Okay, this is first linear scale we need to find vernier constant, here for circular scale this is least count. So least count means pitch divided by number of division. Pitch divided by number of division. What is pitch? Pitch means for one full circle rotation, that is for circular scale, one full circular scale rotation from 0 to then again 0, the main scale reading is the pitch. Okay, so here the given the for one main scale, 1 millimeter main scale reading correspond to 100 division. That means pitch should be 1 millimeter. Okay, and number of division in circular scale. So circular scale number of division is here a 100. So that means this is n. That means least count should be 1 divided by 100 millimeter. That means 0.01 millimeter. Okay, this is least count. बस और कुछ भी नहीं है, सिंपल पुट योर डेटा इन द फॉर्मूला, दैट इज मेन स्केल रीडिंग और डायमीटर. मेन स्केल रीडिंग हियर इज गिवन 0 मिलीमीटर, सो डायमीटर फाइनली डायमीटर इज इक्वल्स टू MSD, दैट इज मेन स्केल रीडिंग प्लस वनियर को लेना पड़ता है. तो वनियर यहाँ पर क्या है, वनियर रीडिंग मतलब सर्कुलर स्केल रीडिंग इज 52 एंड दिस इज circular scale reading. We need to convert it in main scale reading. So you just multiply this list down 0.01. Okay, formula is MSD plus circular scale reading CSD into list count. Okay, we just put over here. So main scale reading is 52 plus 50 into circular scale reading is main scale reading is 0. Main scale reading is 0 millimeter plus 52. This is 52 here. 52 into 0.01. That is 0.05 millimeter. Of course millimeter, because main scale reading is also in millimeter and our list count is also in millimeter. So right answer is okay. Just this is the tricks over here, that is answer is in centimeter, so you should convert it in centimeter. So 0.52 millimeter means 0.052 centimeter. Okay, so answer is option 1. Okay, so must see your options properly. Okay, so your answers in millimeter but option is in centimeter, so you need to convert it. Okay, this is question number 5. A small block slides down on a smooth inclined plane starting from the rest at a time t equals to 0. Okay, this is suppose an inclined plane here, over here. Okay, this is the inclined plane. This is inclined plane. Suppose this is theta, the angle with ground or horizontal axis. Okay, now it's starting from rest at t equals to 0. So is this inclined? Suppose this is a block over here and is going to going to start moving from rest at t equals to 0. Let Sn be the distance traveled by the block in the time interval t equals to n minus 1 to t equals to n, then the ratio of Sn and Sn plus 1 is. Okay, basically as we know that Sn means, what is Sn? We know S means displacement. What is Sn? Sn means this is also displacement, but not all over, not from 0 to time t. This is the total displacement. This is total displacement, but it's not total displacement. This is called nth displacement because n is a time. Okay, nth displacement. Suppose a car or any block is moving. Okay, from t equals to 0, after that 1 second, after that 2 second, it moves. Time goes on 2 second, 3 second, like this. okay, and it comes over here. Okay, now anyone says what is total distance or total displacement? This is our total displacement. But if anyone say what is S3, okay, if anyone says what is S3, that means in third second what is displacement. So this is first second, 0 to 1, this is second second, that is 1 to 2, and this is third second, that is 2 to 3. So this displacement should be from 2 second to 3rd second distance or displacement. This is called third displacement. Okay, so that's why SN means N minus 1 to Nth. In this time period, the displacement is SN. Okay, so just try it, then we'll go for solution. Okay, so here this is the block. This is block. Okay, and is started from t equals to 0 second. Okay, so what is the equation of SN? What is the equation of SN? As we know that u, this is the equation of motion from straight line motion. You can get over here. Okay, SN equals to u half a 2t minus 1. Okay, if you take n over here, then you just put n. Okay, just this is the displacement of n nth second. Okay, so for this condition, okay, suppose this block is here, then if the mass of this block is m, then this is mg. Okay, this is the two component over here, like this and this. This is, if this is theta, then it is also theta. Okay, this angle also theta. So this component should be mg cos theta, and this is mg sin theta. This is the force for this block sliding. Okay, so if this is force, then what should be the acceleration? Acceleration means force by mass. That means mg sin theta divided by m. So mm get cancelled, then g sin theta. So g sin theta, the acceleration if this block is sliding. Okay, so just put over here, and it started from rest, so that means u equals to 0, and half into a means g sin theta, that is acceleration for this sliding, and 2n minus 1. This is SN. We got SN. But another thing we have to calculate, that is SN plus 1. That is SN plus 1, because we have to find the ratio of SN and SN plus 1. So if this is SN, okay, just take a minute. Okay, so now SN plus 1. Okay, so SN plus 1. What should be N plus 1? Just put N plus 1 instead of N. Okay, the same equation is for N plus 1. That is U into U plus half A into 2 N plus 1 minus 1. Okay, just we can put n plus 1 with n plus 1 instead of n. So what is this equation? And u is 0 for this also, so just half into a into this is 2n and plus 2 and minus 1, that is 1, that is 2n plus 1. Just calculate it, this is so simple. So we got this s n plus 1, that means sn by sn plus 1 means this divided by this. So I mean just okay, I mean as we karte the hai ki half g, okay, just put g sin theta in a, so that means g sin theta into 2n plus 1. So all are get cancelled out and our final answer is 2n minus 1 and 2n plus 1. So that means 2n minus 1 and 2n plus 1, that is option C. Option C or option 3. Okay. This is our right answer. Okay. For any doubt, you just write in the comment section. Okay. अगर वो कमेंट अगर सही है तो मैं कमेंट करके जरूर रिप्लाई दूंगा. ओके ओके, दिस इज नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. अ बॉल ऑफ मास 0.1 केजी 0.15 केजी इज ड्रॉप फ्रॉम हाइट 10 मीटर स्ट्राइक द ग्राउंड एंड रिबाउंड्स एट द सेम हाइट. ओके, दैट वाज लाइक अ बॉल एंड दिस इज ग्राउंड इन फॉलिंग देन रिबाउंड from the surface. Okay, the magnitude of impulse imparted to the ball is nearly, so you need to find impulse. What's the equation of impulse? That is change in momentum, that is final minus p initial. Okay, this is change in momentum, that is impulse. Okay, just try it. Done. If you've done this, then it's really good. Okay. This ball is started from rest. That means u should be 0. So if you want to find velocity, because momentum is what? Mass into velocity. So you need to, mass is given here, but you need to find velocity first. So what should be the velocity? So at point, at the point near to the ground, suppose A, this is A point or O point. Okay. Now this is height, that is h. Okay, so height is given here 10 meter. So velocity is b square equals to u square plus 2 g into h. That is u is 0 here, that is 2 g h. So v equals to root over 2 g h. Okay, so just put the value of all these things, that is g is 10, that is given here, and a is also given here, that is 10, that is 200 root over 200. Okay, that means 10 root 2. Okay, meter per second. So this is the velocity near to the ground of the ball. Okay, that means after style it rebounds, that means whenever it started to rebound, that velocity also v. Okay, so but direction is changes whenever it falls. Direction, say suppose this is negative, suppose this is our axis, this is x, this is y, then this downward means minus axis, that is minus j. This is positive j plus j and this is minus j. So in initial condition it was minus, and in after that in final condition that is plus j. So in momentum, in of course in coordinate system, that is mg. Okay, or okay, just take it mg, not mg, m into v j cap minus m into v in j cap, and in first case that is minus j. Okay, that is minus j because this is downward. So just put over here, m means 10 and v means 10 root 2, and minus is here because this is minus j, and this is m is 10 into v means 10 root 2, that is plus j, and this is also j over here. Okay, so what should be the answer? Oh, sorry, v is there, m means 0.1, sorry, 0.15. okay, 0.15, this is the mass value. Okay, 0.15 into 10, that is 1.5 into root 2, and this is adding, because this is minus, so minus 2 into point, that is 3 root 2 minus into j cap. Okay, this is our answer. But okay, root 2 means 1.414 into 3, this is nearly more than 4, that is 4.2, this is the answer, nearly 4.2. okay, just multiply it, 4.2. so this is our impulse imparted, exerted in the ground. Okay, this is the answer. Clear? Okay, next question. Question number 7, a particle of mass m is projected with velocity v equals to kve, where ve is escape velocity from the earth of the surface. The maximum height above the surface reached by the particle. This is a very interesting question, very interesting question. Just try it, after that we go for. Okay, so suppose this is suppose this is the earth surface, a particle, okay, thrown in this direction. If it reaches escape velocity, तो क्या होता अगर ये पार्टिकल एस्केप वेलोसिटी रीच कर जाता. देखो यहाँ पर देखो v इक्वल्स टू इक्वेशन है कि k इंटू वी इंटू ई, सॉरी v इंटू नॉट ई, वी ई, दिस इज एस्केप वेलोसिटी, एंड दिस इज द कंडीशन, दिस इज द की पॉइंट ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन, दैट इज k इज लेस देन 1. k लेस देन 1 इसका मतलब क्या है, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस? k लेस देन 1 मीन्स this is the less than 1 value. So whenever we multiply any value that is less than 1 with any bigger value, it goes to less than 1. Okay, so of course this v is less than v. Okay, just a correction, not this is अगर इसको मल्टीप्लाई किया तो इसका वैल्यू कुछ नहीं होगा, इसका वैल्यू जरूर चेंज होगा. अगर इफ के इक्वल्स टू 1, देन वी शुड बी वी, ओके, दिस शुड बी वी. इफ के इज लेस देन 1, देन ऑफ कोर्स वी शुड बी लेस देन वी. ओके, सो द वेलोसिटी ऑफ दिस पार्टिकल इज लेस देन वी, तो हमको पता है कि क्या पता है कि अगर कोई पार्टिकल को एस्केप वेलोसिटी से मूव किया जाए, अगर थ्रो किया जाए, तो वो अर्थ की ग्रेविटी से बाहर निकल जाएगा, वो वापस नहीं आएगा. लेकिन इसको जब थ्रो किया गया तो वो वेलोसिटी एस्केप वेलोसिटी से कम है. इसका मतलब क्या है, ये अर्थ की ग्रेविटी के बियंड नहीं जा पाया है, तो वो रिटर्न बैक करेगा. क्लियर? सो इसलिए इसका मैक्सिमम हाइट पूछा है कि वो कितना दूर तक जाने के बाद वो रिटर्न बैक करेगा. तो दिस इज आवर मैक्सिमम हाइट. ओके, तो व्हाट शुड बी द मैक्सिमम हाइट. क्लियर. ओके, वी जस्ट अप्लाई द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मैकेनिकल एनर्जी हियर बिकॉज व्हेनेवर इट्स थ्रोन लाइक दिस एट दिस पॉइंट what should be its kinetic energy, what should be its mechanical potential energy, all these things we have to calculate. Okay, suppose this is first point, from the starting point this is A to the highest point, that is B. This is Earth's surface. Suppose this is the height, that is h, from the Earth's surface this is the height. Okay, we have to calculate this height. Okay, the maximum height of the ridge of the vertical. Okay, so if we apply kinetic mechanical energy, conservation of mechanical energy, that means at initial mechanical energy, the total mechanical energy at initial is equals to total mechanical energy at final. So at initial, at this point A, okay, so what is mechanical energy over here? That is kinetic energy, because which three weight with velocity v. That means kinetic energy is half m v square. And what should be the potential energy at this point? What should be the potential energy at this point? Okay, in the option, if you see the R is here, that means this R is radius of the earth. Okay, suppose this is earth, this is radius of the earth. That means agar tumne a ground ko zero pakad liya potential ke liye to ek galat ho jayega, because for potential zero at the center. So this is the earth surface, okay, and this length is R, the radius of the earth. So potential energy at this point is g m small m by the distance from center to this point is r. Okay, and this negative sign for me, if you go to gravitational chapter, then you can see this negative sign is comes for to finding potential energy. Okay, so half mv square, this is kinetic energy. Total mechanical energy is here, kinetic energy plus potential energy, which equals to total mechanical energy in at final point, that is B. That is, this is also kinetic energy plus potential energy. So at final point, kinetic energy is zero because particle is in rest, so this is zero. And what is mechanical energy? That is potential energy. It is g m m. This capital M is the mass of earth, and this small m is the mass of this body, because it is given here. Okay, g capital M, this is capital M, small m divided by what? The distance. This is the distance from center to this. So from center to earth surface is r, and earth surface to this distance is h. ये figure में क्या है कि मैंने tilt करके और projectile motion की तरह दिखाया है, लेकिन for earth surface, whatever in the direction, so from this to this distance. Suppose this is r, the radius, and this is h. Okay, so r plus h, this is the total distance from the center at point B. So you just calculate it and you can find the value of v over here. So that is all the m, if you common and just cut it, just v square by 2, cancel out all the m, minus g m by r, which equals to minus g m divided by r plus h. Okay, So just put it in the right hand side, then v square by 2 which equals to gm by r minus gm by r plus h. Just calculate it, r plus h. So gm in common, that is r plus h minus r, that means h over h. Okay, this is our what, v square by 2. Now what is v? Okay, so as you know that v equals to k into v, just put over here v square, that means v k square into v e square divided by 2 equals to this portion gmh by r plus h. So here v e square is 2 into gmh divided by like this r into r plus h. Okay, now what is v? V means escape velocity, and for r escape velocity formula is 2 g capital M divided by r. Okay, in gravitation chapter you must follow it, that is v equals to 2 gm by r. Just put over here g, v square means 2 gm by r, that is 2 gm by r, and this over here. Okay, so this equals to this, so gm and gm is cancel out, r and r is cancel out, 2 and 2 is cancel out, so we just and this is k square is over here, that is divided by k square. Okay, so just phrase in your notebook. Okay, so h by r plus h which equals to k square, that means we need to find what h. So h means r plus h which is k square equals to h. Okay, I want to start. Okay, so now just common h over here. Okay, so h into k square plus r into k square which is equals to h. So h in common, k square minus 1 equals to r into k square. So h equals to r k square divided by k square minus 1. Okay, this is our this is 1 minus k square. 1 minus k square because it goes to right side, then 1 minus k square, that is, this is 1 minus k square. So r k square divided by 1 minus k square, that means option A, r k square divided by 1 minus k square. Okay, so this is right answer. Okay, next question. A uniform rod of length 200 cm and mass 500 gram is balanced on the wedge placed at 40 cm mark. A mass of 2 kg is suspended from the rod at 200 cm and another unknown mass M is suspended from the rod at 160 cm mark as shown in figure. Find the value of M such that the rod is in equilibrium. Okay, find the value of M. Agar kitne mass ko yahan par hang karne se ye rod kya hoga, equilibrium position mein rahega, yahan bhi tilt nahi karega, yahan bhi tilt nahi karega. Okay, so This is a very interesting question. Just try it and we'll go for solution. Done? Okay. If you done this, this is a very interesting question and this is very very good question for you. Okay, here length of rod is given, that is L equals to 200 centimeter. First, your answer is in SI, in SI unit. So you must turn into all the unit in SI. So 0.2 meter. Okay. 2 meter, this is length, and mass is, that is M, 500 gram, that is 0.5 kg. okay, this is mass. Okay, now at point O, this is 0, I mean this is point O. Okay, at point O. Okay, okay, now if this is in equilibrium, तो क्या होगा कि ये लेफ्ट साइड में या राइट साइड में टिल्ट नहीं होगा. दैट मीन्स जीरो टॉर्क शुड बी देयर. ओके, व्हेन जीरो टॉर्क अबाउट पॉइंट ओ, सॉरी, व्हेन टॉर्क अबाउट दिस पॉइंट इज जीरो, देन ओनली वी कैन से दिस रॉड इज इन इक्विलिब्रियम. ओके, अगर टॉर्क नहीं होगा किसी साइड पर तो अबाउट दिस पॉइंट ओ, ओके, दिस इज द पिवट पॉइंट, देन वी कैन से दैट रॉड इज इन इक्विलिब्रियम. ओके, सो जस्ट अप्लाई दिस कॉन्सेप्ट एंड डू इट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी नीड टू फाइंड द टॉर्क एट पॉइंट दिस. ओके, एंड एट पॉइंट दिस एंड at the center of mass of this rod, because the total mass of this rod is concentrated at the center of mass. Okay, so suppose this rod, the middle point is here, so this is center of this rod, so this is center of mass. Okay, the total mass of this rod, that is 0.5 kg, is concentrated here. So first of all, the torque 1 for what? For 2 kg at this point. So 2 kg is here from this point O or 0, from this point to this distance is 20 cm of course, because this is 0.02, this is 20 cm, then 40 cm. 0.2, this distance is 40 cm, that means 40 minus 20, that means this distance is 20. So what is torque? Torque means force into the distance where the perpendicular distance, that means where two forces are occurring. Here this is the pivot point, so from pivot point to the force is occurred, that distance is our R. Okay, so in vector form we can write for torque force into distance in vector form. Okay, sorry, in vector form, that is not force into distance, that is R distance cross force. Okay, now what is R here? R means this is 20 centimeter. Okay, so that is 20. What is F? For 2 kg weight is mg, this is force. So mg means 2 into g means 10, this is given here, that means 2 into 10, this is force, into, for cross product, r cross m, the distance vector or displacement vector is here and force is here. So r cross m means, this is the rotation, r cross m, that means torque direction of torque is outward. okay, for this board or your skin, the direction of the torque is outward, okay, towards you. So this is the direction, and for cross product you can get sine and angle between R cross F. The angle between R and F is 90 degrees, that means sine 90 degrees, clear? And this is the direction of torque. Now just calculate it, okay. And this 20 is in centimeter, so you have to put in meter, then we can get our answer. So in meter, this 20 centimeter means 0.2, okay, meter, that means 4 newton meter, okay, the unit of torque. So sine 90 is 1, and 2 and 2 is 0.4 into 10 is 4, so 4 newton meter is the torque at this point, that is where 2 kg is hanging. Now torque 2 is this is the position, and direction, you must know the direction of the torque, because whenever you sum all the torque to equals to 0, because we want this rod is in equilibrium, that's why all torques should be 0, sum of all torques. So the direction should be remembered, this is outward. Now torque 2 for this position, from 0, from O point to this position, length is 160, and this is 40, that means this length is 120 centimeter. So in meter, that is 1.2 meter, okay. So R cross F, that means same here, 1.2 into mg, this is m, not given the value, so we have to calculate this, that's why we are doing this. So m into g is 10 into sine 90. And what's the direction of this torque? Because from this point to this m point, that is where m is hanging, displacement vector is here, and mg force is here. Sorry, force is here, that is mg. So displacement into force, agar cross product kare to direction should be what? In the inner side, okay, cross into the page, okay, this direction is out of the page, because R cross F, if you curl your fingers, then thumb direction should be direction of cross product. So if you curl your fingers, then the direction of torque, and if you curl your fingers from where? From this R to F. So here R is this and F is here. So R cross F means, if you curl your fingers of the right hand, not left hand, you should remember this. If you curl your fingers in right hand, then from R to F, then thumb direction should be direction of this. Okay, so this is into the page, cross. So 12 m sine 90 is 1, that is cross. Now torque 3 is where? At center of mass, because this mass is aisa mass to hai equilibrium ke liye responsible, but this rod mass is also responsible for this, okay. So you have to calculate this also, okay. So rod mass is m, this is 0.5 kg into g, okay, this is the force, okay. So now what is torque 3, and from O point to this distance is what? This is the total distance, this is should be 100, because the total distance is length is 200 centimeter, that means half of length is 100 centimeter. So 100 to 40, that means 60, 100 minus 40 is 60. So this distance is 60 centimeter. So 0.6 meter into mass force, this is 0.5 into g is 10 sine 90, and of course from O point to this displacement is r, and this, and also this is also into the bridge. So that means this is 3 newton meter. This is also into the bridge. Okay, so if you take this out of the page is positive, then into the page of course is negative. So our final answer should be total torque must be zero, because we want rod is in equilibrium. So total torque must be zero. So tau 1 plus tau 2 plus tau 3 should be zero. Okay, so that is this is plus 4, this is minus 12 m, this is minus 3 m. Why? Because these two are into the page and this is out of the page, that's why this is positive and these two are negative, that is 0. So what is the value of m? 12 m, if we take it is in right side, that is 12 m equals to 12m equals to 1. Okay, that means m equals to 1 by 12. Okay, so 1 by 12 kg is the right answer. Clear? Next question. A car starts from rest and accelerates at 5 meter per second square. At t equals to 4 seconds, a ball is dropped out of a window by a person sitting in the car. What is the velocity and acceleration of the ball at t equals to 6 seconds? Okay, so here a car is moving from rest. You need to attention there. From rest, a car is moving. Suppose this is our car. From rest, this is our starting point at t equals to 0. Okay, and it accelerates at a equals to 5 meter per second square. At t equals to 4 seconds, suppose this is t equals to 4 seconds. Okay, at this position, after t equals to 4 seconds, a ball is dropped out of a window by a person sitting in the car. So inside this car, a person is sitting here and he drops a ball outside the window. Okay, suppose this is ball. Okay, now what is the velocity and acceleration of the ball at t equals to 6 seconds? Okay, after throwing this ball at t equals to 6 seconds, what is the velocity and acceleration of the ball? So how can we solve it? So first of all, you need to find whenever it started to fall, or at the moment of throwing, what should be the velocity of ball. You need to find this first. Okay, so as we know that during the inertia, okay, so as you know that the inertia, whenever it started to fall, its velocity should be equals to velocity of this bus or car. Okay, so the first of all, from this data you have to calculate first the velocity of this car, okay, at t equals to 4 seconds. Okay, because at t equals to 4 seconds, this ball is dropped out. So, u equals to 0 initially. So, you have to find v first. So, v equals to, if you get this, if you try this equation, that if, v equals to u plus at, then easily you can find the velocity at t equals to 4 seconds of the car. And this velocity should be equals to the velocity of ball, because velocity of ball should be that velocity, because at this moment whenever it started to fall, that velocity should be equals to the velocity of car. So u is 0 here and a is 5 into time is 4, that means 20 meter per second. Okay, so this is basically if the man throw this ball, this is basically the vertical horizontal velocity, you know, this is 20, sorry, this is basically 20 meter per second. Okay, now after that, so this velocity should be velocity of ball, clear? Now you need to find also whenever it okay, now our question is what is the velocity and acceleration of the ball after t equals to 6 seconds. Okay, t equals to 6 seconds means from t equals to 0 to t equals to 6, that means you need to find the velocity of ball at t equals to 2 seconds. Okay, because after 4 seconds it dropped, that means at t equals to 2 seconds, that means after 4 seconds plus 2 seconds, that means 6 seconds. So that means you need to find velocity after 2 seconds, then you can get total velocity of the ball. So this is like a projectile motion, you know, suppose suppose this is the ball and it's throwing like this, and whenever after t equals to 2 seconds, from 4 seconds to, because this is the confusing part here, that is the ball find the velocity and acceleration of the ball at t equals to 6 seconds, that means after 4 seconds plus 2 seconds, because you need to find the velocity after 2 seconds, because total time is 6 seconds from 0 to 6, and these 2 seconds is after 4 seconds. Okay, total time is 6 seconds. So this ball is throwing, so after that this ball after 2 seconds, suppose this is our motion of the ball because it's dropped down. Suppose after 2 seconds this ball is here. Okay, this is the t equals to 6 seconds total time from 0 to 4 plus 2, 6 seconds. So as we know that in projectile motion, after 2 seconds this is our horizontal velocity vx, suppose this is equals to vx of the ball, vx can't be changed, but our vertical velocity should be changed. Okay, so what is the vertical velocity of the ball? Vy, we can use the same equation, uy plus a into t. Okay, what is a? What is a? A is the acceleration of this ball. So as we know that for free fall or any, whenever no force is act on this, only gravitational force is act here, so ay should be equals to 10 meter per second square, equals to g. Okay, and the ball started from 20 meter per second in the direction of x or horizontal, but we need to find in y direction velocity. So initially there is no component of this velocity in y direction, that means uy equals to 0. So uy equals to 0 here, and ay is 10, and t equals to 2, that means this is 20 meter per second. So we got vx and vy, that means horizontal velocity of the ball and vertical velocity of the ball at this position at t equals to 6 seconds. So the net velocity is vx square plus vy square, vectorically you just adding them. So This is 20 square plus 20 square, that means what is that is 20 root 2. Okay, this is the velocity of the ball. So our option is here 20 root 2 here, 20 root 2 is there. But you need to find also the acceleration. Acceleration, what should be the acceleration at this point? Because of free fall or anything, whenever no force is act there, that means only g is there. So only acceleration is there is g, that means 10 meter per second. So option A is our right answer. Clear? Next question. Okay, question number 10. From the circular ring of mass m and radius r in arc corresponding in a 90 degree sector is removed, the moment of inertia of the remaining part of the ring about an axis passing through the center of the ring and the perpendicular to the plane of the ring is k times mr square, then the value of k is. Okay, this is basically center of mass problem, so just try it. Okay, I think you've done it. This is very easy question for you. Suppose if you take us this, okay, this is a square. Okay, just try firstly. Okay, this is our circle. Okay, this is a circular ring. Mass is m and radius is r. Okay, now corresponding to a 90 degree sector is removed. 90 degree sector means, suppose if you cut the ring in a 90 degree sector, that means like this. This should be 90 degree, this angle. So this portion is removed from this ring. Okay, so it's look like this. Okay, this 90 degree sector is removed from here. So what should be the mass of this ring? Because this is the total mass of the ring is m. So if 90 degree sector, the 90 degree sector means, suppose this is the total ring, and if you cut in four pieces, one piece is removed. That means m by 4 mass is removed from there. Clear? This is the total mass of the ring is m, and one piece, because if we divide into 4 equal pieces, this is the 90 degree sector, 90 degree sector, 90 degree and 90 degree, total 360 degree. So you remove one part of these 4 pieces is removed, that means m by 4 mass is removed. So what should be the mass of this remaining part? That means m minus m by 4, that means 3m by 4. This is the mass of remaining part. Okay, now they asked me or asked us that what should be the moment of inertia of the remaining part of the ring about the axis passing through the center. That means this is the center, so axis passing through this center, you need to find the moment of inertia. Okay, in terms of, that means k times mr square, k times m, because as we know the moment of inertia, something mr square should be there and some constant part is there, so you need to find the value of k. So just calculate it, because moment of inertia, moi moment of inertia is equals to integration dm, that is mass portion into r square. So here dm, the total mass, if we integrate dm, small dm anywhere, small dm part, if we integrate the total, we can get total mass of this ring, because total mass is there 3m by 4, that is 3m by 4 here, and r is a radius, is same here, capital R, that means r square. Okay, r is constant here because throughout radius is r, so if we remove from this integration, that means r square dm, this is the total mass of the ring. Now if we put here integration dm means small masses are adding and the total mass is 3m by 4, because this is the mass of this ring, okay, after removing the 90 degree sector. So we got our answer here, that means 3 by 4 m r square. So if we compare with this term, k m r square, that means k into m r square, that means k is equals to 3 by 4, that means 3 by 4 is our right answer, option 2. Okay, next question. Waterfall from a height of 60 meter at the rate of 15 kg per second to operate a turbine. The losses due to frictional force are 10% of the input energy. How much power is generated by the turbine? Okay, you need to find power of this turbine. Okay, just try it. After that, you can see the solution. Okay, now, okay, what is power? Power means, power is energy by time, as you know. So here, this is some rate of change here. This mass is changing because whenever water is falls, not a constant mass always falls, this mass is changes with time. That means here we need to concentrate on that change in power, that is incident power on the turbine, that is incident power on turbine, del P equals to what, that is D E divided by dt, energy by time. And as we know that this power is from potential energy, this energy is a potential energy, so d mgh divided by dt, because it falls from certain height. Okay, suppose this is 60 meter height and water is falls and there is turbine. So whenever it the water consumed on 60 meter height, its potential energy was mg into 60. Okay, so this energy is converted into kinetic energy and it falls on this turbine. So this energy should be this energy. So this is mgh, the total potential energy, and that energy falls on this turbine. So incident power should be energy by time. So here m and g is constant, m is variable because 15 kg per second here, because this is changing with time. So g and h, because 60 meter is constant here, so g and h is constant here, so dm by dt here, mass is variable. So variable mass is given here, so don't worry about this. So 10 into 60, g value is 10, h 60 meter, and dm by dt given here, that is 15 kg per second, that is 15 kg per second. All are in SI unit, so you don't need to worry about this. So just calculate it, 15 into 6, that is 80 and 00, that is 15 into 6, 9000 watt. Okay, so 9000 watt is the incident power. But our question is, losses due to frictional force are 10% of the input energy. So some power is losses due to frictional force. So power generated by turbine, 10 after 10% loss, the remaining power should be our answer. So 9000 the total power, here 10% is losses. That means 1 minus 10%. 99,000 watt into 1 minus 10%, because 10% is losses. So it was 99,000 into 10%. Sorry, 100. This is 100, okay? So 2020 watt, so 900, this power is losses here. So our answer is 9000 minus 900, that means 8100 watt. In answer is in kilowatt here, so just divide by 1000, that means 8.1 kilowatt. So our answer is option 3. Clear? Okay, now the another question on escape velocity. From the escape velocity from the Earth surface is V. The escape velocity from the surface of another planet having a radius 4 times of the Earth and same mass density. Then what should be the escape velocity of another mass? Okay, this is a very easy question. You need to know the formula of escape velocity. Okay, already we discussed in our earlier question. So just put it that formula, and instead of mass, we just calculate the another planet mass by using the density of the Earth. Okay, just try it. Then after that, we go for solution. Okay, let's try. If you got the answer, just write down in comment section. Okay, I'll definitely reply you. Okay. So escape velocity of the Earth is given as, this is V. So V, sorry. So V is escape velocity of the Earth. So V root over 2gm divided by R. This is the formula of escape velocity, where M, capital M, is the mass of Earth, and capital R is the radius of Earth, and G is the universal gravitational constant. Now in our question, the 4 times of this is the mass density, is one term is there, so you need to convert mass in terms of density. So as we know that density means, our density rho means mass by volume. So if we converted mass in terms of density and volume, then we can write here g, 2g, mass means rho into rho, this is the density of Earth, into volume. As we put Earth as a spherical surface, that is 4/3 pi into capital R cube, that is radius of the Earth and capital R. So just solve it, 2g rho, and this is 4/3 here, that is 8 by 3 is here, and R square. Okay, so if we go for another planet, the question is, another planet for having a radius, another radius, suppose say whatever R1, say the 4 times of the R radius, that is R1 is equals to 4R, and the same mass density, that means rho is same for another planet. So that means this term is constant for another planet also, but this part is variable. So if we put here, this is constant, suppose you can say that is k, that means k into r square root over total, so that is k into r. Okay, this is the escape velocity of the r. And escape velocity for another planet, suppose V1, we can say here k part is constant for another planet also, but R part is different, that is R1, that is k into 4R. That means if we put here we need to find, okay, K into R, this is V into 4, that means 4 into V. So the another planet, for another planet, the escape velocity should be 4 times of the escape velocity of the Earth. Here V is given, not V, but it doesn't matter, 4V. So 4V is the right answer. Okay, so escape velocity, if density is same here, then escape velocity varies, or escape velocity is proportional to R. If R is 4 times, then escape velocity is also 4 times. Clear? Okay, another question. A particle moving in a circle of radius capital R with a uniform speed takes a time t to complete one revolution. If this particle were projected with the same speed at an angle theta to the horizontal, the maximum height attains by h equal to 4 hertz, then the angle of projection theta is given by. Okay, let's try it. Okay, I hope you done it, because this is a very easy question. The question देखने में बड़ा है, लेकिन solution बहुत ही छोटा है, एकदम simple है. If you know the formula of projectile motion, like maximum height, then you can got this answer easily. Okay. So here our question is, the moving particle of radius r uniform speed takes time t to complete one revolution. If a particle complete one revolution with velocity, suppose like v, okay, then what is the formula of v? V means s equals to vt from this is the equation. So v means s by t, that means distance by time. So distance by time, okay, there's a speed here, so speed means distance by time. So speed, what should be the distance? If the radius is r, then for one complete revolution, distance covered is 2 pi r, the circumference of the circle. That means 2 pi r divided by capital T, because this is the time takes. Now, this is a V of the particle. If this particle were projected with the same speed, okay, if I projected this particle with same speed, okay, with same speed, this is the speed and this is the projectile motion here, okay, this is V, then, okay, this is the angle theta with horizontal, the maximum height attains, which equals to 4 R. If this is R, and so this is 4 into R, okay, this is the maximum height. Now the angular projection theta should be, so as we know that for projectile motion, if you remember it, maximum height equation, that is velocity square, the starting velocity, sine square theta divided by 2 into g. You must remember this formula. For projectile motion, the maximum height should be v square sin square theta divided by 2g. This is the theta and this is our initial velocity. Now, you for this question, this h is equals to 4r. That means this equation should be equals to 4r. Clear? और कुछ भी नहीं करना है, सिंपल यू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ थीटा. फर्स्ट यू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन थीटा, दैट मीन्स साइन स्क्वायर थीटा, ऑल टर्म्स जस्ट पुट इन राइट इन साइड, सच इज 4 राइट इन साइड 4 आर इंटू 2 जी डिवाइडेड बाय वी स्क्वायर. ओके, दैट इज 8, is it right? Okay, 8rg divided by v square, and you need to put the value of v, okay, because in option V is not there, that means you need to put the value of 2 pi r square, that is 2 pi r by t whole square. Just calculate it, just solve it. 8 r g t square divided by 4 pi r square. Okay, so this is 2 r g, 1 r is cancelled out, sorry. Okay, I can write in refresh form, 2 g t square, okay, by, sorry, pi square is here, pi square into r. Clear? So what is sin theta? Because this sin square theta is this, so sin theta means just root over is, so you can write here for root portion is power of half this. So what is theta? So theta should be sin inverse this portion. So in option sin inverse is there, and there 2g t square pi square also, this is our right answer. Clear? Just here you need to remember this formula only, and all these parts are calculation part. Okay, v square sin square theta by 2g, and I hope you must remember. Okay, this is next question. This is basically from as you know that this formula that coming from magnetism, that is magnetic kind. So from this formula you can easily find anything, but this is basically, this formula is given here, this formula. So this is basically from vector equation. So we can just calculate all these things using vector, dot product, dot cross product, whatever. Okay, so for vector portion we can easily calculate the value of b. Okay, the product, in product a equals to q into v cross b. Okay, and this is the component of b is there, bi plus bj and b naught k cap. For q equals to 1, v is there and f is given, what should be expression of b. Okay, let's try. Okay, this is very easy question, just vector cross product. So let's try it. Okay, a is given here, q is value is given here, v gap is given here, and b expression is there. Just you need to find b, b and b naught. Okay, so just put here, a is given, that is from this equation. Okay, in this equation just put 4 I gap minus 20 j cap plus 12 k cap equals to q value is 1, so you need not to be right here, and into in bracket v cross b, v is given here 2 I cap plus 4 j cap plus 6 k cap. Okay, not bracket, and in cross product b expression is there, b I cap plus b j cap plus b naught k cap. Okay, so this is basically cross product between v and b. So just find the cross product I, j and k. This expression from v expression 2, 4 and 6 is there, and from b expression b, b, b naught. Just find the cross product I cap. So this column, this column and this column is cut. Just multiply 4 b naught minus 6 into b minus j cap. So for j cap, second column should be omitted and just multiply 2 into b naught, 2 into b naught minus 6 into b, and last k cap. So k cap column jo hai wo ab chupa ke just multiply b 2 into b minus 4 into b. First the this cross, then this. First 4 into, okay, this two. Okay, first this one 1 and second 2. First 2b minus 4. Now you must remember this. If you convert it or change it, suppose you did first this one, then minus sign will come. So you must remember first do this product, then this. This is 1, this is 2. First do this, then this. Okay, so just calculate. This is b naught and 6b is not down. This is also and this. If this is remaining part here, and if we calculate this, that is k cap into, that is minus k cap into 2b. Okay, so this is remove here. Okay, now if I compare both sides, that is 4b naught minus 6b I cap, here I cap component or is 4. So 4b naught minus 6b, which equals to 4. If we compare, then we can get our first equation this. Second, 2b naught minus 6b should be equals to 20, and this minus sign and this minus sign is cutting. Then 2, just write down here, 2b naught minus 6b is equals to 20. This is second equation, and our third equation is 2b is equals to, which equals to 12, but here minus sign is there, that means minus 2b is equals to 12. So first you need to find b first, because this is only b here. So b is equals to minus 6, you got it. So in this equation, if you put here, because this is our expression of b, you need to, you not need to find b naught also, because in options, option a and option option 1 and option 3rd, in option 1st and option 3rd only 6 is there, and option 2nd and option 4 8 is there. So 8 is not our answer, because we got answers b equals to minus 6. That means 3rd option should be right option. Okay, but for calculation portion, for part, you need to find b naught. So just put the value of b in first equation or second equation. So if I put in first equation, so 4b naught minus 6 into minus 6, which equals to 4, that means 4b naught, which equals to minus and minus plus 36 equals to 4, that means b naught, which equals to 4 minus 36, that means minus 32 divided by 4, that means minus 8. So b naught should be minus 8. Okay, so option 3 is right answer. Okay, all done. So for NEET 2021, from unit and dimension to gravitation, all these 14 questions is given for this year. Okay, so our second video will come soon, and for that video we'll cover the second part of class 11 part. Okay, like sound oscillations, kinetic theory, all heat portion we will cover. Okay, just stay tuned and subscribe this channel.
Thank you so much.